identification of the claimants or the disputants is imperative. It is a basic requirement that the witnesses identify themselves, whether it is a trial, civil, criminal, or theological. The witnesses must identify themselves. And in that, the first witness, according to the subject advertised, is the Quran. The subject is the Quran or the Bible, which is God's word, the Quran. Let us see what the Quran says about itself. We want to know the name of the book. What is the name? Who is the author? Let the Quran speak for itself. In Surah Rahman, that is chapter 55, verse ayah number 1 and 2, Allah says, Ar-Rahman wa'allam al-Quran. It is Ar-Rahman, the merciful God. It is He who has taught the Quran. The name of the book, Quran, and the source of revelation, God Almighty. The Quran speaks for itself. Some of you, my brethren, I can see that you are smoking, please. This is a very serious topic. It is against the rules of this arena for people to smoke. Please put down your cigarettes. Surah Rahman. To help you, my brothers and sisters, to find this reference in the Quran, it's difficult for the non-Arab, most especially for us, Pakistanis, Bangladeshis, for us it's difficult to find references such as Rahman. Where do you find Rahman? In the Quran, which is an encyclopedia of 2,000 pages, this particular one I have in my hand, with 114 chapters, surahs. Where will you find Rahman? If you have a translation like this, this is by Abdullah Yusuf Ali. It's available in the foyer outside. A translation like this. You open the index at the back, and the R, just like in a dictionary, look for Rahman, and it'll tell you 55. And 55 is easy to find. Once you have found 55, ayah number 1 and 2, verse 1 and 2, easy to find. This book is so cheap. It's a very ill-fitting word. I say it's so cheap. 2,000 pages, an encyclopedia of 2,000 pages with Arabic text, English translation, and commentary. 2,000 pages for £5. You, people in Britain, will appreciate this value I'm talking about. When I had to buy the Holy Bible from a big booksellers here, Hudson's, this Holy Bible cost me £9.95 plus VAT. You get two for the price of one, two, and they are available. I'm not here to do business, but by the way, they are available. You owe it to yourself. There is no better wedding present you can give, Christmas present you can give, birthday present you can give to your employer or to your employee than the Quran, as well as you need it for yourself. And again, the Quran speaks about itself in Surah Jashia. Look for it under J. Jashia, ayah number 1 and 2. It says, Tanzeelul Kitabi min Allahil Aziz al Hakim. That the revelation of the book is from Allah, the exalted in might, full of wisdom. Chapter 45, ayah number 1 and 2. The Quran identifies itself that I am the Quran and the author is God Almighty. Coming to the Bible, the Holy Bible, no doubt on the face of it we have the words Holy Bible. Who put the word Holy Bible? The printers. Beautiful calligraphy, beautiful the calligraphy. In this vast volume described by Dr. Sharosh in a previous meeting as a library of 66 books, he forgot that the Roman Catholics have 73 books. But between the 73 of the Roman Catholics and 66 of the Protestants, the word Bible is not in the Bible. It's an amazing situation. The witness hasn't got a name. He's anonymous. In the vast encyclopedia, the word Bible is not in the Bible. This is a concocted word, concocted by learned men. They got this word Bible from the Greek word Biblos. Biblos means a book, from which now they got the word Bible. Bible means a book. It is not a name. But though today we use it as a proper name, the Holy Bible, but the Bible is not in the Bible, and the Bible doesn't say that I am the book of God. We will prove to the contrary. But let us see what the Christians themselves, they say about their holy book. I have here a book. Is the Bible the word of God? Big question mark. This question is asked by Dr. Graham Scroggie, and it is published by the Moody Bible Institute. They are not the Moody people in America, but the title name of the printers are Moody Bible Institute. They printed this book. The idea is to prove that the Bible is the Word of God. And in this book, before I come to that, I have given a reply to that book. In a booklet of mine, is the Bible God's Word? And this booklet was supposed to have been given out to each and every one of you. In case you haven't got it, I take it on your way out, will be given one. If you don't get it from the Islamic Propagation Center in Birmingham. It's absolutely free. This gives you an idea of what the Bible is, what the Torah is, what the Zabur is, what the Injil is. See, generally the Muslims don't know. Though we say we believe in the Torah, we believe in the Zabur, we believe in the Injil, what these words signify, the Muslim does not really know. So if you want to know, here is a book, they'll give you all that in detail. But coming to the Christians themselves, what they say about this holy book. Dr. Graham Scroggie, he quotes on page 22 and 23, a certain Dr. Joseph Parker, who says, this is to prove that the Bible is the Word of God. He says, what a book is the Bible. This is typical American. You know, the way that, what a fantastic, what a lovely bunch of people. You know, what a fantastic group of people. This is, what a book is the Bible. In the matter of variety of contents. You know, variety is the spice of life. Things that are different. In the matter of variety of contents. This is, whole pages are taken up with obscure names. Names you never heard before in your life, and you're not likely to hear them in the future. Obscure names. And more is told of a genealogy than of the day of judgment. Stories are half told, and the night falls before we can tell where victory lay. He's asking, where is there anything in the religious literature of man to correspond with this, to compare with this? And we have to admit, nowhere. But does that prove that it is the book of God? That is what we are going to analyze. Phrase by phrase, whatever the man says, let us analyze the serious implication of his utterances. Like this, he's tantalizing, he's mesmerizing people with words. Beautiful necklace of words, meaning nothing. Listen. He says, whole pages are taken up with obscure names. You don't know what he's talking about. So, here is a page from the Bible. I'm going to read out these obscure names.